Of the various genres to have produced consistently great-looking games over the years, racing games are probably worth considering. The sheer output isn't as much as one would like, but with the effort and painstaking detail that some titles demand, this is more than understandable. Let's take a look at 15 graphically stunning racing games that have been released in recent times. Gran Turismo Sport. Whether this is a true franchise sequel or not, Polyphony Digital's Gran Turismo Sport is superb. It's razor sharp in its focus on photorealism, which is aided by lighting, material quality, global illumination, and real-time shadows for everything. Vehicles look highly detailed, whether it's reflecting the outside world or when admiring from the driver's seat. With numerous cars and tracks added over the years, Gran Turismo Sport is the way to go before Gran Turismo 7's release. Project Cars 2. Slightly Mad Studios deserves some credit for creating its own series of realistic racing sims in a world dominated by Forza and Gran Turismo. And while Project Cars 2 isn't quite at the same echelon, it's still a worthy visual achievement, with sharp car models, dynamically shifting weather, gorgeous ambient lighting, and so much more. Granted, its best performance is on PC, but it's worth it for all that detail, not to mention the 12K resolution support. Forza Motorsport 7. Similar to Gran Turismo Sport, realism is the key to Forza Motorsport 7's visual style. It achieves this at 1080p and a rock-solid 60fps even on the base Xbox One. This is despite having to balance over 700 different cars and dozens of track layouts. The details on each car are immense, with extensive polygon counts and physical-based lighting, while environments are crafted using photogrammetry. High-resolution textures and refresh rates, better image quality, and more can be found in the PC version for even more visual oomph. Forza Horizon 4. Compared to the Forza Motorsport series, Forza Horizon is about creating a large, detailed open world along with numerous cars and activities. Forza Horizon 4 is the very best iteration of this, especially with its changing weather conditions via seasons. The physical rendering, material-based shaders, and texture quality help bring the over 400 cars to stunning life. But it's the deformable terrain, parallax occlusion, and stellar streaming technology that makes the world feel natural. Drive Club. What else can we say about Drive Club that hasn't already been said? Its weather effects are beautiful, from volumetric fog to snow, which are made even better with the addition of dynamic weather post-launch. Of course, despite running at 30fps on PS4, the use of post-process anti-aliasing, high-resolution textures on cars, and realistic lighting and shadows still holds up to this day. Drive Club may have been delisted from the PlayStation Store, but it still lives on in our hearts. Need for Speed 2015. Strange as it may sound, Ghost Games' Need for Speed title from 2015 still looks very good to this day. Even on console, the quality of weather effects and road textures, materials on cars, and atmospheric lighting is incredible. This is taken to another level on PC with HBAO, temporal anti-aliasing, and maxed out geometry and effects details. How it looks arguably better than current Need for Speed titles is beyond us, but the results speak for themselves. Dirt 4. Codemasters is no slouch when it comes to its flagship Dirt series, and Dirt 4 showcases just how far the developer's Ego engine has progressed. The game's rally cars are captured well, but it's the effects of mud, water, and other weather effects that highlight the extensive wear and tear they can face. Draw distance, texture quality, and shadows are also similarly strong, and all of this comes at no expense to the frame rate, especially on consoles. The Crew 2. Ivory Tower's The Crew 2 had a tough task on its hands, what with all the different kinds of vehicles and large play space it had to build. To that end, the frame rate and draw distance are admirable, though the latter isn't always perfect where pop-in is concerned. Various environmental details like trees and cityscapes, lighting and texture quality also manage to look great compared to the original, making The Crew 2 worth a look, if nothing else. Assetto Corsa Competizione. As the follow-up to Assetto Corsa, Competizione utilizes Unreal Engine 4 to dole out better environments and an overall better visual look. Closer inspection showcases some lackluster vehicle details, but it's not a deal-breaker. The simulation aspect is still very strong, and if you can look past some performance hiccups as well, then it's definitely one of the better-looking racing sims. just not quite on par with the likes of Forza, Gran Turismo, Project Cars, and so on and so forth. Dirt Rally 2.0. Codemasters does it again, this time adding physical-based lighting for cars and track degradation, where tracks are worn down in real time and can affect one's handling. This is on top of improved shaders and materials for cars, better lighting and shadow quality, and strong draw distance. All of this, and the game runs great at 60fps on both consoles and PC, so what more could you want? Xenon Racer. Car models are rife with details and particle effects, especially when boosting looks this good. Tracks and environments also sport good shadow quality, lighting, and textures, though you will need to play on PC for the most solid frame rate. F1 2019. Physical-based rendering isn't F1 2019's strong suit, and thus results in materials looking low quality at times. If you can get past this, though, the game still offers good-looking cars and environments backed by excellent post-processing effects and per-object motion blur. Screen space reflections are similarly on point, and overall performance is very solid. It might not beat out Dirt Rally 2.0 in visual fidelity, but for Formula 1 titles, F1 2019 is still top tier. Asphalt 9. Gameloft's Asphalt 9 garnered a hefty amount of acclaim for its graphics, and it's easy to see why. For a game running on mobile devices, it manages to provide great post-processing quality, high-polygon model cars, and screen space reflections. This is an addition to great particle systems, a full HDR pipeline, and very little pop-in. Yeah, it murders the battery life on older devices, but if you've got a top-of-the-line mobile, well, then Asphalt 9 is good for putting it through its paces. Grid 2019. Grid 2019 kind of slipped under the radar last year, but still managed to impress with its visuals. Particle effects and weather look decent, material quality and textures on cars look good, and even the crowd is fairly well rendered. While the requirement on PC can be fairly high, it's definitely the best looking version since the ambient occlusion, shadow quality, post-processing effects, and anti-aliasing can be further bumped up. Onrush. Developed by the former Evolution Studios, Onrush is a more fast-paced, arcade-style racer that utilizes objective-based teamwork. The sheer amount of particle effects, strong polygon counts, and 60fps framerate gels well with all of the vehicles on screen. Environments use photogrammetry and come off looking way better than the average arcade racer, and the work put into simulating various seasons, dynamic weather, and so on is stellar. It's almost crazy to think that all of this took only 2 years to develop. And that about does it for this video. If you enjoyed what you watched and want to see more from Gaming Bolt, you can always hit that subscribe button and turn on the bell icon next to it. That way you will never miss any of our videos.